Welcome again to this third tutorial for the course Inglés 4. Again, we're going to be reviewing some of the grammar that you're going to find in your book, Ventures 4. Today, we're going to look at indirect WH questions, indirect yes-no questions. Indirect WH questions. Now, before we start writing indirect WH questions, we're going to be using these introductory clauses that you're going to find in the book. I have written four of these introductory clauses. I need to know, I don't know, can you tell me, do you know? Okay, for more introductory clauses, you can check page 148 in your book. Okay, let's take a look at these questions. Direct question, what grade is Carlos in? Okay, I have written the verb in green and the noun in blue. Now, we're going to change this to an indirect question. Do you know is going to be the introductory clause that was part of the list that I wrote in the past slide. Do you know what grade Carlos is in? As you can see, I have changed the order of the verb and the noun. In the direct question, I had the verb before the noun. In the indirect question, I have the noun and then the verb. So remember, when you use do you know, you're going to end this question with a question mark. Next example. Why did he break the window? Okay. In this question, we're using the auxiliary that is telling us that this question is in the past tense. As you can see, the verb is in green. I'm going to use I wonder. Again, this is an introductory clause from the list in the second slide. I wonder why he broke the window. As you can see, we got rid of this auxiliary and we changed the verb to the past tense. As you can see here, we have the auxiliary did and the verb break. But in the indirect question, we got rid of did and we changed the verb into the past tense. Next question. Where does he live? Again, I'm using this introductory clause. I would like to know. We get rid of the auxiliary does, okay, where he lives. I would like to know where he lives, okay? We're using s with the verb because we're referring to the third person. Okay, indirect yes, no questions. Again, we are going to use the same introductory clauses. I have listed four of them. I would like to know, I don't know, can you tell me, do you know? Notice that when I use can you tell me, I'm going to end this question with a question mark. Again, the same with do you know, ends with a question mark. So for more introductory clauses, please check your page 148 in your book. Here I have two examples where I'm changing from direct to indirect question. Do you like pizza? Could you tell me if you like pizza? As you can see, in the indirect question, I'm getting rid of the auxiliary and I'm using if. Could you tell me if you like pizza? Next example. Are they students? I wonder if they are students. Now, this question is different than the first one. In the first one, we're using the auxiliary and here we're just using the verb to be. Okay? So there is nothing to get rid of, like we did in the first question. I wonder if they are students. What is going to change here is the position of the verb. In the direct question, you had are at the beginning, and in this indirect question, you're going to have are after the pronoun they. And that's the end for this third tutorial. Thank you.